right, let's kick off the show with our organizing and efficiency expert, Kristen McCray from Organizing in Our Eye. Kristen, how are you?
How are you?
So good to see you once again. So we are tackling a subject today that everybody has to deal with. We're talking about laundry.
Everybody has to deal with laundry. And you wouldn't believe how many people hate doing laundry, have piles of laundry all over the house, are overwhelmed by laundry. Like, it just goes on and on. Like, so many people are overwhelmed by laundry.
Well, and I mean, I had always thought, I wish that someday I could make so much money that I never have to match socks again.
Oh, right?
You could just buy as many socks as possible so they all just match and you never have to worry about
it. That's it.
Wouldn't that be fun?
That'd be great.
But,
sure.
But, you know.
We're going to solve that problem for you today.
We all have to deal. So before we kind of jump into it, you have 10 kind of tips that can help us get organized in our laundry.
Yeah.
But before we get into that, you have some strategies that you wanted to talk about, things that we can do while we're doing our laundry.
Yeah, definitely. So think about using your timer on your your washer or dryer as maybe for your time management. Put your laundry in, set it, and then maybe go do some things in the house during that time. The buzzer goes off, that's gonna say, all right, good, I'm done now. I can go back to doing what I was doing before. Like, use it as time management. So maybe you need to, if I'm writing my article for this, for Go Local, I'll sit down and write my article. I know the wash is in. I know I have 5 minutes left to finish my article because the buzzer's gonna go off, and then I go get the laundry, put it in the dryer, and then I move on to something else. So use it as a time gauge, almost like a timer, like an egg timer, but it's, you know, some people think you can't do other things while you're doing laundry. Everybody's like, I don't feel like doing laundry today. Think about you're making dinner, do your laundry. You're helping the kids with their homework, throw a little laundry in. Like, little things like that, it doesn't mean you have to, like, stop your whole day to do laundry. You can plug your laundry in your washer, go about what you're doing, and then go back and put it in the dryer. So many people think they need to, like, set out hours of their day just to do laundry, when you can be doing other things in the house and have your laundry going at the same time.
Even if you use a laundromat for whatever, you can be getting stuff done. Take your computer. A lot of places have Wi-Fi now.
Yeah, exactly. If you have to go to the laundromat, bring like a whole bag of stuff to do while you're there and check it off your to-do list. So think about multitasking when you're doing your laundry. So many people don't do that. And when you put it in that perspective, it makes sense to actually, you can get so much done while you're doing laundry.
I like that. So that's kind of our bonus tip. I wanted to get it in before we even got started.
Okay.
So 10 things you can do to simplify your laundry routine.
Yes.
So number one, you said plan ahead.
Yes, and so many people don't plan ahead. So think about maybe today's Thursday, so next week, look at your schedule for next week and look where any holes are in your schedule where you can actually plug laundry into your to-do list for the week. Or if you have a certain day you want to use as laundry day, like Saturday morning or Saturday evening, or I don't know, you know when your days are free during the week. And if not, if you don't have a set schedule every week, again, look at your to-do list for the week ahead and plug it in your to-do list of when you're going to have that block of time where you can tackle your laundry.
Not just, the bin's full.
Exactly. You have to plan ahead to do it.
Right. Make a day.
Put it on your to-do list, it'll get done, hopefully.
Okay, number two, pre-sort.
Pre-sort your clothes. So whether it's having, you know, some people get overwhelmed because there's too many, it becomes overwhelming when it's a pile
towels
on the floor.
Mixed
exactly.
With sheets are mixed with your undergarments, are mixed with kids, dirty everything.
Right. So if that's something.
Sporting equipment.
Everything. So if that's something you struggle with, think about maybe having the bins that you can sort out when you put your whites in one, colors in another. So that might help you. Some people get stuck with that. So think about pre-sorting. And if you need to put a pre-sorting bin in everybody's room, do it for a little while just to get everybody in the habit of sorting out their clothes.
Okay.
Get everybody on board with this.
And that can also be fun, too, especially for little kids, being able to learn this goes here, get this goes here.
Exactly.
Right?
Teach them young. They're going to have to do laundry at some point. Everybody, like you said, everybody has to do laundry at some point, unless you have, you know, you have tons, millions of dollars and you have a maid do your laundry for you. You don't have to worry about it. But, yeah, everybody's going to do it at some point. So teach your kids young how to even just sort these clothes.
I find it interesting when I hear stories of people who went off to college and didn't know that they had to wash things.
Yeah.
That they didn't know they had to wash their sheets because someone had
done it for them all these years,
their whole life.
Yes.
I always find that. I mean, I guess I had parents who loved me and took care of me and did my laundry for me as well. But eventually, I had to learn how to do it.
Right,
so.
Right.
But why not start when you're a little kid? Right.
Right. Exactly. You have
just
to do
organizing
it
and helping along.
Right. You wouldn't believe how many kids don't know how to fold their own clothes.
No.
And you have to do that at some point, too. So teach your kids how to fold at the same time. I think we're going to talk about that, too.
Well, then you don't have to do it.
Right. Give them some of the responsibility.
Okay. So number three, separate by person.
Sure. So again, if this is one, because everybody has different areas where they struggle with laundry. I've been in so many homes where it's different areas. So this is another area where people struggle. Organize it by person if you have to. If you have to do your, just if you have a son and daughter and you want to just do your son's laundry one day and then do your daughter's laundry another day. That way the clothes don't get mixed together. You do that load, you fold it, it goes back in their room and you're done with it. Then you can do another load of somebody else's laundry. That's another tip that you can, you know, be more efficient that way if you're struggling with putting everybody's laundry together and then sorting and everything that way.
I kind of like that. That way, you know, if you have your work clothes and your workout clothes and then your kids and whoever else, you know, that might make it easier rather than just lumping it all together.
Yeah, and then when you're done with your son's clothes, put them in his room and give him the responsibility of folding them and putting them away. So that's one less thing you have to do. So you just take that whole basket, put it in his room, and let him take the responsibility of folding it and putting it away.
Okay. And next one, complete the task. That's a big one.
It's a big one because I can't tell you how many people have baskets of laundry all over the house. And then what happens is we go to organize and they're like, well, this is clean, but we have
it. Is this clean?
Yeah. I don't know if it's clean or it's clean that's been sitting there for weeks. And they say, well, I'm just going to wash it all over again. Now you're washing clothes, clean clothes all over again. So complete the task. Again, before dinner, throw a load in the washing machine. After dinner, throw it in the dryer. And then after it's done, fold it right away. And that eliminates missing socks. Because if you're putting in a load and tackling that whole load from start to finish before putting another load in or mixing it, now you're not going to have missing socks. The same socks that went in are coming out, and that's how you keep your socks.
No, the dryer eats them.
No.
Sorry, my hands are cold.
That's okay. But that's what happens. Yeah, so try and complete that task from, and I know people out there are going to say, Kristen, I can't do it. It's just, you know, I want you to just think about making the time. Just focus on this one little habit. Focus on this week or next week while the kids are getting back to school and just try and do the task from start to finish and see what happens. You're not going to have barrels of laundry laying around, you know, after the fact. It's going to be done in a way so that if you can look, you know, look forward to that, not having to have these baskets of laundry all over the place.
So is completing the task then putting everything away, or do you say just at least fold them?
No, I want you to put everything away.
Put everything away.
That can
be a couple hours then, you know,
no,
if you're
how
washing.
How do you have?
A lot, right? Well, especially if you have a whole family, right?
Well, no, yes. So
if you have a family of four, then you're washing, drying, you have towels, you have sheets. So, I mean, if you're doing a bunch of laundry, right?
Yeah.
And then you're folding, and then you have to go put everything away in multiple closets.
So just take it one load at a time.
Okay. Well, I'm thinking, I know people, my husband, he does a good job with this. He washes, dries, folds, and puts away all in one swoop.
That's what we want you to, that's what I want you to do.
Yeah.
So then, before you even start that next load, that other load is put away. So don't even start that next load until you finish that task from start to finish. That's how you're going to alleviate piles all over the house and what's clean, what's not. So yeah, just like he would do, start to finish, then go get another load and put it in the washing, or put a load in the washing machine while you're folding. Just keep the cycle going.
Yeah, keep it rolling.
Exactly.
I also like to wash certain things like work clothes rather than like
socks,
dish towels, like everything.
Yeah.
You know, I don't, no thanks.
Right. And then that's more efficient too. After you dry that, now you're just folding towels and putting towels away.
Yeah. So depends on how you can prioritize and organize how you do your laundry, right?
Yeah, you have to think about how you're functioning. Yes.
Yeah, exactly. What works for you.
That's all about.
Complete the task. I like that. I think that's a big one, and you have to commit to that.
Yes, commit to it.
Folding. You said create a folding station.
Sure. So where are you folding the clothes? Are you folding them on the dining room table, but they really don't need to be, they need to go upstairs in a bedroom? So after you finish that one load, when you take it out of the dryer, bring it into the actual room where these clothes are stored. Again, whether it's your kids' rooms, put the basket in your kids' room, have them fold it. If it's your room, bring it to your room. Or if it's everybody's room, just bring it to one centralized location up near where it, at least it needs to go, and it's not on the dining room table. Once it's on the dining room table, it's going to get stuck there and it's not going to move. I see that happen too.
Oh, they get stuck.
I see a lot. So
delegate, which we kind of talked about this.
Yeah, so think about giving your kids that independence. So delegating, like, even if you don't want them to do the laundry yourself. My mother would never let me do the laundry. She's probably watching this. She would never let me do the laundry. She thought I'm such an animal, I'd break the machine. So she used to do the laundry when I was living at home. But then she'd bring it in my room and I would fold it and put it away. So at least that task is done. And then obviously when you get older, but at least give your kids that independence, and that'll help keep their rooms organized because now they know what they have, what drawers they need to go in. So now they're maintaining the organization in their bedroom.
I like that. Giving them the little responsibility.
Yeah.
I like this one. Is it really dirty?
That's the thing too. I have clients that have kids that have an overabundance of clothes. So what happens when they have an overabundance of clothes? They are dirty, but then what happens is the laundry doesn't get done or the laundry piles up because they're still wearing all the backlog of clothes that they have. And what happens there is it just becomes an endless cycle of laundry. But if they only had so many clothes, then you'd be just doing one load or two loads and then putting them back in their closet, they'd wear them again and go out. So reevaluate how many clothes your kids have. If they have like an abundance of clothes, like I'm talking way too many clothes that you only need, you know, clothes for the week, few weeks out. And that would prompt you to do more laundry because now they'd have, you know, just the clothes that they need. But yeah, so going forward, think about what they need, how much they need, and then...
And if, you know, if you wear a shirt once, is it dirty? If you wear a pair of jeans once, are they dirty? Some people need to wash their jeans every time. Some people don't wash their jeans for 3 years.
Right, and that's all a preference. And just think about, is it really... I know with kids, the clothes, they do get dirty. But as you're adults, like, are your clothes really dirty? Like, I'll wear a pair of jeans, like, 3 times before, because then they just wear out faster. And they're really not dirty. I wore them for, like, 2 hours, and then I'm going back home. So think about that. Are your clothes really dirty? Not the, obviously not the kids' clothes that are rolling around in the mud, but your clothes, you're as adults,
kids'
like...
clothes.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. You want to wash them.
Reuse. So think about, you said, with the shower towel.
Here's another one. This is a preference. How often are you washing your shower towel? Like, so I'm not talking about the towels that you take off and throw on the floor, the kids throw on the floor to reuse. I'm talking if you get out of the shower, use a towel, hang it up on a hook, and then use it again for the week, and then wash it at the end of the week. You're clean when you get out of the shower. As long as you're hanging that towel right up again, I'm not talking about people who, like, you know, throw the towels on the floor and the bed and walk over them and that kind of stuff because it ends up being dirty. But think about how many towels you're washing a week and if they're really dirty, if they're clean or dirty.
So. Yeah. Okay. Organize your laundry room.
This is a big one, too. So, again, you want your spaces to be as efficient and productive for you as possible. Because, again, you don't want to spend hours looking in the laundry room for things or misplacing things. So, before you get on this plan to tackle your laundry on a regular basis, I want you to reorganize your laundry room or organize it to make it work better for you and help you become more efficient in the laundry room when you're doing laundry. Do you have enough laundry baskets on hand? Do you have where your soaps are supposed to be? And, you know, you're cleaning out your lint. A drawer in the dryer as you're supposed to be doing it. Like, little things like that. Like, just organize the laundry space. It'll help you become more efficient and more productive while you're there.
Plus, you'll want to be in there, not, freaking out about it. Mm-hmm. And then you said make it easy.
Make it easy. So many people think, you know, when they don't make their laundry, a lot of people don't want to make laundry a priority. They just don't want it. People say, I hate to do laundry. But what do you hate about that process? Do you hate actually putting the clothes in the washing machine? Do you hate taking them out? Do you hate drying them? Think about it. And I want you to think about, back in the day, before Facebook and all the social media, people say they can't find time to do laundry in their day. Think about how often, you know, we're on Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn, all these things, and how long it's taking you, like, it's taking you away from things that you need to be doing
you
in the house.
Like, have to do it.
Right.
You wear clothes.
Right. I mean, back in the day, was everybody, like, wondering where all the time went? I think so many people are on social media now, it's a time zap. So even if you say, I'm going to put a little laundry in and go on Facebook for 20 minutes and then go check your laundry and then... So in the amount of time you're on Facebook, maybe it's an hour, hour and a half a day, you could do like 2 loads of laundry during that time. So think about prioritizing your time management. Because so many people, again, it's a chore for them to do laundry. They say they hate to do laundry, but what is it that you hate about doing laundry? And how can you best prioritize it to fit it in your day and finishing it, you know, taking from beginning to end that task of doing laundry?
Make it easy, make it simple. Make it fun, put on some music, do something, right?
Exactly. And like I said, it's great, like you say you don't have the time, but think about when you're doing dinner or those other tasks when it could be running. So, and again, the socks, the missing sock thing is a huge thing. I helped a client not too long ago, we had a basket
socks.
Of socks, just emptied the socks on the bed and went through.
I made a sock box.
Did you?
Like,
a lot of people have a sock box.
Make a sock box, throw them ones that you don't know where they are, throw them in there, you'll find them eventually.
Yeah, so...
If you don't... Use them as a rag.
So what I'll do is I'll do like, I have to go home and do laundry today actually. So I'm going to do probably about 4 loads of laundry, but at the end of all the 4 loads tonight, I'm going to fold it all. So there'll be no missing socks because I know all those socks are in those 4 loads.
She's a magician.
So sometime.
She's a magician. She's magically creating more time for us by being efficient and organizing us.
Yeah, that's all it is about, creating more time for yourself. You want to be able to spend time on the things you love to do, but you have to still do those other things that you don't want to make a priority, but they have to get done. So you have to prioritize your time to get them done.
I like that. Christy McRae with Organizing in Our Eye. She'll be back with us next week. Yes. And of course, you can always read her columns on golocalprov.com. Thank you.
Thanks,
so much,
Molly. Thank you.